I'd like to get two things said, get them straight before. I told Brad that I was not upset or disappointed in anything, but jumping around, I thought this should be that exciting. Some people get disappointed or mad when other people do that, but you should be excited and heard, you know, it's over. And, he hadn't been there this whole every time that he's had to listen to it. So first of all, I'm not disappointed at all of you. I understand other people have other desires and dreams too. And the second thing, and the most important thing, that loss is my fault. No question, no doubt in my mind. My first year at Kansas, we allowed Kansas State to make a 3-10 regulation when we were up 3. And I turned to my bench, and Coach Robinson was there, said, "You should fire me today." And ever since then, every time I've had a chance, I've fouled down there. We didn't have a timeout that I wanted because I didn't think my team was settled before B-Rob went to the free throw line. I didn't know that we had the right personnel in, and so I used that timeout there. I would love to have had that other one that we called when there was a loose ball on the floor, but the player did what he was supposed to do. So we have the timeout, and I talked to him to tell B-Rob because I wanted to give him confidence. And that was the number one thing I wanted to talk about, was to give him confidence to make the shot. I told him, "You've got this. This is your time. You're going to make these free throws. And after you make these three free throws, we're going to play 22. We're going to switch any screen on the ball." And that was it. They're dribbling the ball across the 10-second line, and I said, "You didn't remind them to foul. We do it in practice. I believe in it." I've had some great moments as a coach, and I'd say that right now this is my lowest one because losing this game was my fault. I told them if I die tomorrow, or 20 years from now, be the biggest regret I have in 32 years as a coach, because these kids really need me. And coach let them down today. So, I'd be happy to answer any questions.
To be in that position, the way the press offense struggled there the last couple minutes, you guys had that issue against UCLA at the start of the second half. What went wrong?
People didn't get to the right positions, and people didn't come to meet the ball. And the last thing we did to practice yesterday was press offense work, but still in the excitement and the toughness of the game, we didn't get where we're supposed to. You're not supposed to throw all those long passes, and the one that Leakey threw, tried to throw over the guy's head to Garrison, he made a nice play on it. Not press offense, it's just giving the ball.
Roy, at the end of regulation and even in overtime, I know you talk about the streak just being a number and all that stuff, but do you think it weighed on those kids at all? Do you think that it may have crept into their minds when that lead went away?
I don't think so. You'd have to ask them, but I don't think so. I think the our inability to handle the second half against Pitt probably had more to do with it than the streak against Clemson. But, you know, we just found out, and I'm not blaming Leakey, make sure you understand this, we just basically found out today that Jeremiah wasn't going to play, and that's the second time this year we found out within 24 hours that the point guard wasn't going to play. And so Leakey was in that position that he hadn't been in that much. Even though the one man is not supposed to take the ball out of bounds on the side, it's usually the three man. But I said, "Leakey, you're used to this, and Leakey's our best passer in size, and so that's the reason I got him to do that." At that point, I was probably thinking more clearly than I. Guys, I did run behind the ball.
Anybody else?
I'd tell Bubby she'd probably fire me. Probably wouldn't be a bad idea. Coach is supposed to help his kids. Sure, I don't mind answering.
Anybody have anything else?
Roy, the last 2 minutes, I mean, could you feel it? Something changed? Was it in your players' heads a little bit?
I think the first turnover leads to another one, leads to another one. I think it does that. I mean, and again, they throw the ball in the street, guy, the point's supposed to go to the middle floor twice in a row. We didn't do that. And, you know, some mistakes. And again, it was the last thing we worked on yesterday, the very last thing. 10-man press offense. In fact, we did press offense, defense game, which means the teams alternate. But I decided that I didn't want to work on our press. I just wanted to work on our press offense. So we didn't work on any press defense. It was just press offense.
And then after that, in overtime, they went back door.
Yeah, you know, the crazy thing is they hadn't gotten one of those. I don't think they'd gotten one of those the whole game. And we know that that's part of their offense. And one of the clips that you showed on tape was Sims throwing that back door pass off the dribble. But those kids, they made a mistake. Not as bad as the mistake I made, because I didn't remind them of that.
How good can this week off be for you guys, considering it'll be 4 weeks since Cole's surgery on Monday, and Jeremiah, we don't quite know. Maybe you could tell us what his status is.
They're going to do some more, I don't know what you call it, maybe an MRI, maybe be some x-rays. They're going to do some of those, some examinations, maybe even tonight. And we won't know until we get the results of that on Jeremiah. The week off. I'd like to play tonight. I told you guys before, I wouldn't like to be a football coach. We have to wait a week. I don't have any idea how it'll be. We're going to give them some rest, and then we'll get together and practice again. But we won't know on the injuries until we get the information.
Coach, Brandon really made a point of attacking tonight and obviously played very well. What did you make of his performance tonight?
You know, it's he's beating himself up because he had one of the three turnovers, but I thought he did some really great things. And he's a senior, wants things to be better. I've told him before, you know, things in life don't always work out. You have to face some adversity and you have to come back, keep coming back. And I'm very hopeful. In fact, I strongly believe that my team will keep coming back, And the injuries, you know, it's more than we've ever had, but nobody's going to feel sorry for North Carolina. It's okay.
Roy, what did you tell your players after regulation heading into overtime to try and get them to forget about what just happened those last 2 minutes?
That now they missed two free throws that were big. You know, I said, but now they're fired up. We're just going to play five more minutes and let's play even better. Let's be stronger than them. They're very happy right now. And let's be really strong and go out and play well. And gave up, I think, two of their three were up the back door cuts. And, you know, that hurt. But, I was very positive with them. And, you know, that's a good sound. Happy for Brad and his team. My team would have had a better chance of doing that if I ever mind.
Thanks, Coach. Thanks, Brown Allen.